Proceed with the presentation. Synopsys is the largest electronic design automation company, and our primary areas of focus are electronic design automation tools, semiconductor IP, and manufacturing tools. Almost all the electronic devices that you use today have integrated circuits and printed circuit boards, which are designed, verified, and manufactured using one or more of our tools. And our revenues were close to $2 billion in the last fiscal year. And we have about 9,225 employees worldwide, 60% of whom are having a master's degree or a PhD. And some of our top customer names include Applied Materials, Global Foundries, Intel, Qualcomm, IBM, Samsung. I would like to give a brief background information about our team, because this information will be useful in some of the content that is going to come later. So my team, we are a global team of about 26 writers. We prepare the product documentation for Synopsys' AMS and SCG products. So this is the kind of tools that we use. We use a structured FrameMaker for creating our content. And we use WebWorks ePublisher to create online help collections of our FM book. We use Acrobat to generate the PDFs of the same FM books. And we have an organization-wide system called Perforce, which is used for documentation, archiving, retrieval, and version control. Coming to the main presentation itself, so this is going to be the outline of my presentation. I will discuss with you the content reuse challenges that our writing group is facing. I will tell you why we did not want to take the content management system route to enabling content reuse. I will tell you how we discovered this tool called Insight Plus, and how we built our content reuse solution using this tool, Insight Plus. I will discuss the pros and cons of our solution and also touch upon what we plan to do in the near future. So as I mentioned earlier, we prepare product specific documentation for AMS and SCG products. There is a lot of cross integration between products in our group. That is, we have products with common basic functionalities. We have product sets where one product is called within the interface of another product. We have products that interact with each other. We have different flavors of products for different customers. Sometimes our new products combine the best features of one or more existing products, and so on. So as writers, we needed to prepare a documentation specific to each product, but most often the content in one document was only marginally different from the content in another document. And also the part of the content for a new document was already available in the existing documents. And also we, as writers, we needed to quickly respond to changing demands for product documentation while maintaining the accuracy and consistency of information in our document sets across products and releases. So we didn't have an efficient and effective content reuse mechanism in place. To meet these demands, so writers resorted to ad hoc methods like copy-pasting and conditional text. But what we found was in the medium term, keeping these documents updated between products and releases was becoming very difficult. There was a lot of wasteful time and effort going into, you know, maintaining those disconnected copies synchronized and updation of these copies. In the beginning, we too thought that a content management system is the solution for content reuse, so that we could quickly and efficiently create documents, and also we could you know, maintain the accuracy and consistency of information in the documents across products and releases. So we explored the market for you know, standard content management systems, and we found that they were expensive and they had extensive features, yet none of the CMSs that we evaluated met 100% of our perceived needs. As I mentioned earlier, we already had an organization-wide system for documentation, archiving, retrieval, and version control, and writers managed their own workflows. So we were evaluating a CMS only for content reuse, So it was not a cost-effective solution for us, and also we felt that the features in a standard CMS were extensive and very excessive. And also the CMSs that we evaluated required extensive customization to integrate seamlessly with our existing writing, production, and version control systems. That is, we had to heavily customize the CMS to make use of our structured FrameMaker DTD and tools, or we had to move our documentation source to Dita, which we were not we didn't want to do. And some of the CMSs were complex and required training to use, and writers will have to switch between the FrameMaker GUI and the CMS GUI while working, which was inconvenient. And last but not the least, we believed that our documentation tool, Structured FrameMaker, is versatile. And in Structured FrameMaker, content is chunked into elements. And for content reuse, we only needed a simple solution that will enable sharing of some of these elements across our documents and books. So our objectives were an inexpensive solution for content reuse, no complex tool. The solution has to be compatible with our existing writing and production systems and revision control system. And the solution should leverage the markup of structured documents and enhance it to allow granular content reuse. And we also needed a simple and easy to use solution. So with those objectives in mind, we explored the market for suitable tools and structured FrameMaker plugins for content reuse. It was then in the internet that we came across this tool called Insert Plus. So Insert Plus, it's a free tool, and it allows for content reuse and structured FrameMaker. So this tool is from West Street Consulting, which is owned and managed by Russ Watt. He's a technical writer himself. So what it does, it allows you to copy and reuse structured FrameMaker elements along with the structure and data between documents and books. That is, it provides menu-based commands for previewing content for reuse, and then actually setting up reused content, editing reused content, updating reused content, tracking and clearing your reused content, and so on. It provides more features and flexibility as compared to text insert feature of FrameMaker. So these are the capabilities of Insert Plus. First is that the reused modules are live and editable. If you remember the text insert feature of FrameMaker, the reused content is not editable. Whereas with Insert Plus, whenever you reuse content from a source, you can edit the reused module as the case may be. And also you can update a reused module from the source whenever required. Insert Plus also provides a reverse path to update a source module from the reference module or the reused module. And there was no limitation on source and reused modules. This means that depending upon what is the common content between your document, you can reuse entire chapters or sections or procedures or lists or tables as the case may be. And also it supports nested reuse. That is, source modules can insert other source modules, and there's no limit to the level of nesting, and better visibility and management of reused content. Once you have created these reused modules, they act like any other content in Structured FrameMaker. You can navigate to them, you can view the structure and data in your reused modules, you can edit your reused modules, you can update them from the source, you can even delete them. In addition to all this, Insert Plus provided some menu-based commands for reused module coloring for better visibility, and also for tracking your reused modules in your documents and books. And it also supported tracking source module usage. That is, you can see where all a particular source module is being used. And use of books as source module repositories. That is, you can put multiple source modules in one single structured FrameMaker file. You can save several such files in a book and then point all your references to that book. So in this way, you can create a database of source modules, and the database will be nothing more complex than a structured FrameMaker file or book. Yes. Reverse path, yeah. Yes.
And in one of the files I updated,
yes.
I expect a reverse path to happen. Will it happen in all the cases where the source?
No, it won't. See, you can update the source from one reference, then the, all the other references will not be updated. Whereas when you're, see, INSET Plus allows you to update all the references in your document from a source. And, but when you're using this reverse path, it is only between one particular reference and the source. So normally that is, I mean, it's not used, but you know, there may be situations where, you know, if need be, you can use that. It's an optional capability.
Yes.
It works only for FrameMaker, structured FrameMaker, yes. Yeah. So how INSET Plus works? See, a module of content is stored in one location, which is called as a source module, and you can reuse it in multiple locations. That is, you can create references. And a reusable source module, it is nothing more complex than a valid EDD element with a unique value assigned to its ID attribute. And a reused reference module will use the same element tag as its source, and you will insert it where you want to reuse the source content. And the reference module will point to the ID and file name of the source in a content reference attribute, which you will have to define in the INSET Plus settings. And for each INSET reference, INSET Plus uses the content reference attribute to locate the source and insert its structured content in the reference. And for those of you who are familiar with DITA tools, INSET Plus is based on the DITA conref mechanism. So I've brought some examples to illustrate how INSET Plus works in Structured FrameMaker. So this example illustrates source module reuse. So my source module is a section in the first book, Camelot Install Guide. So INSET Plus provides a menu-based command to reuse the source in another document. And after you reuse, the content reference attribute, in this case called conref, points to the file name and ID of the source. So in the same way, you can reuse other elements in your EDD, say, procedures, figures, tables, lists, and so on. And as you can see, the structure and data within the, once you set up reuse, the structure and data in the reference is the same as that of the source. And INSET Plus allows you to, if need be, edit this reused module as you please. So this second example illustrates that concept of live and editable reused modules. So the reference module in the previous example, which is there, has been edited to include a body and a table before the procedure. And the table here is again a reused module from another source. Reused module update from the source. So again, INSET Plus provides a menu-based command to update all the references in your document or a particular reference in your document from the source. So here, in this case, the source, there has been some changes. A body list and a figure has been added before the procedure. So using an INSET Plus command, you can make your reference up to date with the source. So then the changes in the source are reflected in the reference. And the reverse path would update the source from the reference. Yes.
Do you also get an indication of where all, you know, something has been referenced, how many files and what are the file names?
Yeah, INSET Plus has this INSET reporting as well as source module tracking feature. So using those features, you can create those kind of reports.
But it's not something that you would get as a, you know, as a kind of a checkpoint before you're saving the file?
No, you will not get that kind of a, you will have to find out, I mean, you will have to submit a source file to INSET Plus and ask, you know, what are all the source modules in this file and where are they being reused? And similarly, you submit a document and say how many reference modules are there in this document and from which source they are referenced. So it can provide you that kind of reporting feature, But not, you know, it's not a default, by default it does it. You'll have to specifically invoke a menu command and do that.
Okay. And what about, like, you know, macros, etc.? Does it lend itself properly when you create macros?
Macros, I don't get you. What do you mean by macros?
You can create macros in your FrameMaker files, and I mean, does it allow the reuse of those elements?
I have not used macros. I mean, if you can give me details of what is a macro in a FrameMaker. I have heard of macros in Word, but
same thing,
is it? So, I mean, I have no experience using macros, or at least our in our documents we don't have macros. So,
okay, and just. Okay, and just one more question. When you do the optional reverse path, okay, so when you make changes in your reference file, so you've made changes only in one of, let's say, 5 reference files, and consequently in the source file. So does that mean that now the source file is kind of delinked from the rest of 4 of them?
It will not be delinked. The links will still be there, but you can choose to update your other references or not. It's like that.
Okay.
See, once you have created your references, the links are established, unless you go and remove them. So once you update your source from a reference, it's not automatically reflected in the other places. If need be, you can, you know, synchronize them with the source or not.
Thank you.
Hi, this is Sharda. We use Dita and obviously we use Conref, but we do not have a CMS.
Okay.
Can InsertPlus help us in any way?
Dita, is it? It is a structured FrameMaker plugin, but you know, you can check on the, see, this is available on the internet.
Right.
So since our system is a structured FrameMaker, you know, for documentation, so I have explored that part of InsertPlus.
Okay.
So you can check the website, weststreetconsulting.com.
Okay, thank you.
So all the information is there. There is a user guide, tutorials, and things like that.
When you say that all the topics doesn't get updated automatically, then what is the use of content reuse here?
No, there is a command for updating all the reference modules in your document or book. You just, but you know, optionally, sometimes don't have to do it. Maybe at times, you know, some references you want to update, some references you don't want to update. So all those capabilities are built in. It's just a question of, you know, clicking a button, then all the references get updated from the source.
If I'm working on a huge book,
yeah,
then how does it help me?
It's just update all insert references in the book. So you can do that, right? Before publishing, that is what you're expected to do.
Okay.
Before publishing, you're
supposed to... You mean to say that you have a select all options for the topics and do it?
You can either do one or all.
That facility is available. So I'll proceed because the time is going. And this is a sample InsertPlus reuse module report. So this is for the reference file in example 2. There were 2 references. So InsertPlus reports all the references in your document along with their, you know, their element tags, the source file name and the source module IDs. And similarly, you can create a report for your FrameMaker book. This is the typical source module reports will look like this. For a source file, when you submit the source file to InsertPlus for source module reporting, it will say that there were so many source modules in the file, and there are that many references to each source module, along with hyperlinks to each of those references. So then coming to how we built the content reuse solution using InsertPlus, So first, we identified the set of reusable elements in our EDD. That is, elements having more potential for reuse, or elements that writers would want to more often reuse across their documents. So we identified 25 plus elements in our EDD, including section. Reference section is the element we use to document our command references, figure, procedure, table, list, etc. for the pilot system. Then, as I mentioned earlier, Insit Plus uses two attributes of elements for content reuse. One is the ID attribute and the other is the content reference attribute. So all the elements in our EDD, including these 25 plus reusable elements, already had an ID attribute. So we went ahead and added a content reference attribute, which we called as conref, to those 25 plus elements. And the third step was to configure the Insit Plus settings. Insit Plus uses several settings for insit configuration, insit editing, insit updating, and warning messaging, etc. So we arrived at a configuration that was suitable for the entire group and saved the configuration. These are some of the examples of the settings. Like, you have to provide Insit Plus with the exact names of the reusable elements, and also the actual name of the content reference attribute of the reusable elements, and whether it should use relative paths or absolute paths to source files, and so on. So the fourth step was to actually test our system and see whether it works and it serves our purpose. So we had writers take up the initial proof of concept tests with live examples of scenarios in their documents, and the outcomes were all positive. We also did somebody was asking this, we did some timing tests to ensure that documents containing a large number of insits do not take much time to update and all that in FrameMaker 10. So the benefits were many. First is, we could reuse existing content. So for the scenario of moderately divergent content for similar product, we could quickly and easily create content. And this solution allowed flexibility in the granularity of reuse content. That is, depending upon whatever is the common content between the documents, I could reuse entire chapters or sections or lists or figures or procedures, as the case may be. And to accommodate variations in the documents for different purposes, we had this, the reused content being editable feature, so which was very useful. And for the case of duplicated information in multiple documents for similar products, it was, the copies were connected and they could be easily synchronized with the click of a button. So it was easy to maintain the accuracy and consistency of information across our documents. And previously we had writers, to single source content using conditional text and variables. So with this method, I mean, as those of you who have used it will know that, to produce an output for delivery, it is time consuming. You have to carefully proofread all your conditional text settings. Even updating content may not be very easy, but with this method, it was easy to produce accurate output with minimum effort. And also we thought that, we have this boilerplate content in our installation guides, release notes, and user guides. And sometimes from release to release, this information could change. So setting up boilerplate content as reused content from a template, we were able to, manage these changes between releases. And also we had a method to report reuse and track source module usage. But then this solution had a few limitations. First is unresolved cross-references in the reused modules to targets in the source element outside of the source element. So Insit Plus did not have a way of handling that. And also it could not search and locate content for reuse from our content repository. That is, writers could only reuse content from a FrameMaker file in a local file system. Insit Plus was not aware of the content repository and the files in the repository and all that. So this was an important limitation for the multiple borrowers and sharers scenario in our writing group. And it did not, like someone pointed out, it does not provide any features for notifications to borrower and sharer of content. So borrowers are not alerted when something they have borrowed has changed, and sharers are not alerted when someone has borrowed their content and so on. And it could only track and report reuse at the document or book level. So we could not track and report reuse at the product level or teams level or group level and so on. So with keeping these limitations in mind, we are now working on what we are calling as a reuse management system. So reuse management, the heart of reuse management system will be Insect Plus, but RMS will have additional features which will overcome the limitations which I just mentioned. So this will be the kind of a typical workflow in RMS will be something like that, something like what is here. When creating content, writers will have the facility to preview, search, and locate potential reusable contents from the content repository. And after you set up reuse using Insert Plus, RMS will store reuse statistics so that it can report reuse statistics at various levels. Then we will have a method to even handle those unresolved cross references. RMS will also automatically alert sharers and borrowers of content. So we plan to have a solution for all the limitations that I mentioned. So okay.
How does it happen when you have to delete something? Do you get a list of where all it's been referenced? When you have too many content and you decide to maintain and manage it and you want to delete some of it?
Like I said, Insert Plus provides that tracking and reporting feature. So you can submit a book, more books to Insert Plus and tell you to report all the references in the book. And then it will come up with that many references, and these are the sources. The source file names are, it'll provide you the source file names, so the IDs of the source modules, and so on for the references. Similarly, you can use, ask Insert Plus to create a source module tracking report. So it will report all the source modules in your book and where all they are being reused, along with a hyperlink to those reused modules and so on. But again, if content is deleted, there is no notification. That is what we have planned in our RMS. We plan to handle all these kind of situations. You had a question? Actually, the same FM book we submit to our WebWorks publisher, and we produce the help. So it is all, even before we do the help generation, it is all, you update all your references or update only few references. All that is under control of the writers. Once the FM book is ready, we generate the PDF as well as the help, and we have not faced any issues. No special memory requirements, that's what I would say. FrameMaker 10 we are using it, up to 12 it is supported. That much I know. I'm not sure about the older versions of FrameMaker, but I think from 10 to 12 it supports. You can use Insert Plus from FrameMaker 10 to 12. Raswad, is it? He has given us a lot of clarifications on the features, and it is very unsaid that your EDD needs to be updated for to add that content reference attribute, and IDs of the sources should have. There is a lot of help, and the documentation is good, but beyond that, it's a free tool, but the source is not available. It's that kind of a support. But I think he's very open to, in fact, his website says that if we have, we want additional features on Insert Plus, we can write to him. He has said that. So, it's a free tool. You can only use it as a tool, unrestricted license and all that, but the source is not available. No license, but unrestricted license, and everyone using FrameMaker will have to install Insert Plus. So it comes as an extra menu in FrameMaker, and you can.
Not sure whether I, excuse me, here. See there, here. Here. Not sure I missed this point when you are explaining. Does it work only for one writer in one system, doesn't work in a containment, sorry, a CVS kind of an environment?
See, you have to, it will work in a CMS kind of an environment if the writer already knows from which structured framework or file or book he wants to borrow content. If that is aware, if you're aware of that, the writer, you know, could get the latest revision of that file into his local system and then set up reuse. But in a general scenario, I mean, you, when you're trying to, you know, develop document, you would like to have a search and preview facility to, you know, locate what all are the potential sources that are available. I mean, use keywords, search, and then set up reuse. That kind of a facility is not there. That's what we are planning to have.
Okay, so it's like you have to be manually aware where all it is used, kind of.
Manually aware.
Otherwise, the same writer should be doing the things in that system, right?
For a single writer wanting, you know, to manage reuse between her own documents, it provides all the functionalities and.
How are you using in a single writer mode or in a combined?
The pilot system worked very well in a single writer mode. So since now we want to, you know, we are multiple writers. With
do you use SVN?
Perforce.
Okay. Perforce. Does it work there?
SVN. Yeah, we are building that capability into Insert Plus. It still works if I'm aware of you know whose document I want to borrow. If I'm aware of where my source is, I could get it into my local file system and set up.
Okay. Thanks.
I think it has some translation feature also. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. Any more questions? Okay. So I would like to thank Sita for giving us this wonderful and productive session where we come to know about this new tool. So thank you very much, Sita.
Just for you and for Manoj.